Known for its fresh perch and walleye, Vermilion is a great place to drop anchor. But once every year, a metamorphosis into a town crazy about a particular caterpillar.
Even though Mr. Goddard retired from Fox 8, he can never retire from the Woolly Bear Festival.
For Sandy Coe, it's tradition.
My mother, Mo Coe, was a founding mother of the Woolly Bear Festival in Birmingham, Ohio. It's free and it's family fun, and then everybody becomes a kid that day.
At Poppin' Around Gourmet Popcorn, they are trying to meet demand for their special Woolly Bear mix. Inside Brummer's homemade chocolates, it's all hands on deck to prepare 1,300 of this dessert. The 46th annual festival continues to grow bigger than the dream of the man who started it all.
Costume judging.
This area will soon be the center of all of the action. And with just days to spare, it's a team effort to make sure this entire community is prepared for a festival unlike any other.
It's the largest one-day parade in the state of Ohio, or the largest one-day festival.
The Vermilion Police Chief has one piece of advice for first-timers.
Come early and stay late has always been our motto. This is normally a town of around 10,500 people, but when the Woolly Bear comes, we can have up to 100,000 people in this town.
It's my first time being here.
Up to 100,000 smiles as Vermilion prepares for another banner year.
He created it, started as a caterpillar, and he never thought it was going to blossom into something so huge, into a cocoon, into a beautiful butterfly.
In Vermilion.